हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल नंबर स्पीक्स। आई एम अभिषेक महापात्र एंड टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग अराउंड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिमांडेड सब्जेक्ट इन मार्केटिंग, व्हिच इज प्राइसिंग स्ट्रेटजी। सो व्हाट इज प्राइसिंग स्ट्रेटजी? इज द वे यू प्राइस टू द कस्टमर सो दैट दे कैन बाय प्रोडक्ट फ्रॉम यू थिंकिंग दे हैव गॉट huge value or they would be appreciated the way you are serve them. So there are three pricing hack strategy I'll be discussing it to you today, and it is very useful to both product and service industry. So without doing any further delay, let's get into the pricing strategy number one, which is put higher price as an upgrade. So for example, you are selling motorbikes and you sell it at a 50,000 rupees as a basic model without any spare part as a basic. So if you can sell it with spare part, it rise up to 65,000. You can name it as a basic plus package, or you can sell to the customer at 80,000, which would include basic bike plus spare parts plus insurance for 3 years and some special additional services as a part of premium package. So what it will create? As per survey, it shows many opted for the upgrade version, the premium package. Why? Because they rated premium package is less expensive when they viewed it from differential pricing point of view. So they don't have to calculate all these additional things which may sum up to higher for them in future. But when you package it in a premium way and serve it to the customer, they are willing to pay that premiumness and make the purchase. So what you are going to get benefit is the additional revenue to your business. So next, the second strategy, translate the intangible cost into equivalent rupee or dollar cost. So many high quality and sustainable attributes are very difficult to evaluate by the customer. For example, the electricity, the water, the fuel, how much equivalent cost it comes out to be is very difficult for customer to evaluate. So you can play on that. For example, if you have a dishwasher, for example, which is coming new to the Indian market, but let's take this example, which saves 20 kilowatt hour per cycle. How much value does that provide? The solution here is to translate the intangible cost into metrics that resonate with the consumer, in particular rupee or dollar cost, which offer a way to reframe the total cost of ownership in a way that is more meaningful for the consumer. Rather than telling that 20 kilowatt hour per cycle you are saving, you can convert it to a yearly, or I would suggest to a 10-year basis, so that you can say that you can save how much dollar cost just by using the new dishwasher. That's the way you can promote your product. It could be a product or it could be a service. If it is a service, similarly you can talk, if you take the service, you will save this much of cost in so and so forth of thing. For example, if you are taking an analytics solution, you can say that you can improve yourself by 10 to 20% because the analytics value which it will provide, the insight which it will provide, will help you in getting the additional revenue. So this kind of things are also happening right now when the electric vehicles are coming into market. So they are promoting it in such a way that how much money or how much gasoline cost you can save if you bring in an electric car. That's how they are promoting it. So that's another very suitable or very good strategy to convince customer, to make them understand you know, how much benefit they will get by buying the particular product. So moving on to the next strategy, stack discount in right order. So what does this mean? You know, discount is always been one of my marketer's favorite tool for appealing to cost conscious customer. Everyone wants a discount. Alright, this is how the market is going towards. And stack discount refers to a cumulative discount that is, you know, sequentially presented to the consumer. Let's give an example. Offering 20% for the first time buyer discount on top of that 50% holiday weekend sale. You understood? Rather than giving a 35% discount, if I give a 20% discount for the first time buyer and additional 15% discount as a holiday weekend sale. So how that going to play or help? Research shows that the stacking of multiple discount is more effective than providing one overall discount. For instance, taking 10% off plus an additional 40% off is more effective than taking 50% off, even though the lump sum discount of 50% is higher. But consumer always like to go for a 40% plus an additional, sorry, a 10% plus an additional 40% discount on top of that. Yeah, these are the some of the trick you can use. Thank you very much for watching my midweek quick bites on number speak. Thank you very much. Let's see you on the weekend. I have a very, very interesting topic which is very close to your heart we are going to discuss on this weekend. So don't forget to subscribe my channel and meet me on weekend. Thank you very much.